This video will show the process of taking a rapid appliance that was partially indexed on the day of surgery and using it to finish the indexing and then deliver the rapid appliance to a C2F model and then convert the take-home prosthetic. This is delayed by several months. So this was a double arch chrome case completed about five months ago. And the upper was converted, as you can see here, the prosthetic is seated. But the lower, there were some torque issues on three implants. So as we recommend in all chrome cases, if you don't have torque to deliver that day, at least index the implants that were torqued so that you don't have to float this prosthetic in later or have to start really from scratch at implant level. So the doctor placed all six implants, and then because the doctor had torque on these three, added the multi-unit abutments, then added the temp cylinders, and seated this prosthetic on the carrier guide, which is the only time that this prosthetic will be able to be seated during the whole chrome process. It must be on the carrier guide during surgery. So with these three indexed, we can simply come back, screw these in, and pick up these three remaining implants, MUAs and temp cylinders, and index them. So let's go through the process of how that happened in a case last week. When we arrived that morning, the doctor was just kind of getting started. We really wanted to document the whole thing. And in the pan, or in the chrome case, was the maxillary C2F model that we created, the lower prosthetic that had not been converted, and the lower model that was ready for the rapid appliance. Here's the upper that was finished. Looks nice with the small holes. And then we addressed the lower. Now in this case, the doctor had removed all three MUAs and sutured and dismissed the patient. So the first step is to make an incision across the entire crest and expose the implants. And fortunately, in this case, all the implants were straight. So it's a little bit of a cheater video, but all the implants were straight, the MUAs were straight, and so it was a pretty straightforward process to figure out on the rotation of the multi-unit abutments because there wasn't a rotation as in angled. So the next step is to seat all of the multi-units and then torque them into place. And then, because these three sites already have temp cylinders in the rapid appliance, just add these temp cylinders into the three missing ones, place the gaskets for blockout. Now there's no carrier guide, but the blockouts will still protect the abutments. And then you'll notice that these obviously already have temp cylinders in them. So sleeve the prosthetic over the temp copings, and then screw down 1, 2, 3. So now you know it has a perfect positive seat. All right, so now the prosthetic is fixed in the mouth, but then take great care to make sure that there is a gap around the three other temp cylinders or any temp cylinders that you have. You do not want this contacting the side of the prosthetic anywhere. In this case, we had to adjust one of the temp cylinders over here. There's a little bit of an angle. All right, so now it's seated, and then just kind of have a little video here showing how we visually confirmed that everything was down. You know, on a lower, you can have a little bit of a high water design. We'll fix that when we go to final. But just confirm everything is down perfectly. Okay, that way you know that there's no contact here that's holding up that temp cylinder. Then just simply backfill like we always do with a chrome, backfill the void to connect the temp cylinder to the prosthetic. Be sure to use your blockout plugs. You can see here what would have happened. That material could have gone down in the hole. And then unscrew the prosthetic. Right here, and in fact, what we did here was we filled some voids before we addressed the conversion. So we want to make sure there's enough material in here to make sure all these temp cylinders are totally intact We don't want them coming out during the C2F conversion. So with small hole technology, we take the prosthetic back to the lab. We add the C2F analogs onto the prosthetic. We stick them through the model, and then we backfill and connect them to the model, just like this. And we have lots of instructions on this. I'm not going to go through that whole process, but just kind of give some little hints here. All right, so we make the model just like that, and then we put the take-home prosthetic on the model, and we drill the holes. Because you saw earlier, let me go back here real quick, the C2F, this prosthetic has no holes, right? That's the lovely thing about C2F technology. We create the holes by drilling through them on the day of surgery. Pretty simple process. So now we have the holes drilled. You can see the accuracy of Chrome. This was where it was planned, right in the middle, and this is where the implant ended up. All right, so very accurate. And there it is with the holes drilled. And then the next step in C2F is to one by one put the temp coping, the temp cylinder on the model, and then just either adjust the metal or adjust the inside of this until you have a nice positive seat, passive positive seat, and then move on to the next. We started using short and long temp cylinders, so that way you have less adjustment. We just kind of keep these on hand when we go to a surgery. So if you have a situation where you need a short, you grab a short. Instead of hollowing out the prosthetic more or cutting metal down, we're ready to go. Little trick. All right, so then we use the injection ports to connect the temp cylinders to the prosthetic. It's like that. Unscrew the prosthetic from the model because now we've picked up the copings. And then we just go back through and backfill and clean it up. Fill the voids, fill the carrier guide hole, and get the case ready for delivery. Just like that, small holes. All right, and then screw the prosthetic in the mouth. And in this case, the doctor used a material that needed a light cure. And the case was, as I have seen so many times, it was just perfect. Literally perfect. There was no occlusal adjustment needed at all. And here I'll just show a little video. This was the first time we put any indicator in the mouth. So you see all the blue marks right where they should be. Right, exactly where they should be. So doctor's gonna see the patient in a few days just to do a little bit of tap tap, because the patient's gonna be in this for maybe 3 weeks until the tissue settles, and then we go direct to final.